Well, this is a break for us. I haven't been watering very much recently because of the water restrictions. We're only supposed to water twice a week for 5 minutes. But as you can see, it's watering all by itself this morning. This is the second set of thunderstorms that have rolled through. The first ones didn't come this close. It only sprinkled a couple hours ago. But now it's definitely downpouring. Enough to where it's actually doing some good for our poor starving garden. And this lovely little front yard. Now that was less than 1 second away. That was only about 100 or 200 yards away from here. I'm under the roof, but I think I'm going to go inside just the same. I'm going to go inside. Well, it appears that we have lost power. There's another flash. 1002. There have been several flashes within 1 second of the thunder. And on the first one, the thunder lasted for like 3 seconds and we lost power. It's a good thing I've got a battery on this camera. I had a doctor's appointment today. Well, I still have it. It's at 1 o'clock. But since it's not an appointment with a doctor, it's just a class to help me learn about some of the medical conditions I might be facing. Since it's just a class, I couldn't get the robots to cancel it for me. I don't feel like driving out in this, and I'd have to leave in about 10 minutes. No, I'd have to leave. I'd have to take a shower in 10 minutes, and then leave in about 30, 45 minutes, and I don't particularly want to go driving through this. So, I have canceled I tried to cancel it officially, but the robots wouldn't let me, and the human being said, "Oh, you have to use the robot." So I tried 3 or 4 times, and each time, dead end. Too bad. They'll know I'm not there because of the rain. Duh. It's raining, it's raining. It stopped for a while. Now it's back again. And I can't upload anything because there's no way to access the internet without the power. What will I do? I'm back in the Stone Age. And the camera just has a little battery, but fortunately, my laptop has a battery too. But I don't want to use it because I'll wear out the battery. I want to save it for in case the power doesn't come back on for a long time. Anyhow, this must be the third, maybe the fourth video I've made in the storm today. Yum. Wonderful. The garden will be so happy, is so happy. Those lights down there. Are a mockery because we have no power up here. No power in this neighborhood. It's just after 8 o'clock at night, and we've been without power since about 11:15 in the morning. Right after I made the first video of thunder and lightning. Or was it only rain? Killer thunder struck and lightning struck, and the thunder hit less than a second later. Wham! Crackle, boom, bam, boom. And the power went out. A few hours later, my stepbrother came by. After he left, he called on his cell phone 5 minutes later and said he'd seen the transformer down in the middle of the street with the gas and electric truck putting up yellow tape, caution tape, around the dead transformer lying in the middle of the street. Only about a block and a half from here. So that's why the lightning and thunder happened so close together. They were only about an eighth of a mile away. Well, and we haven't had the power back on. There's power off all over the city all day, on and off. And lightning strikes, and thunder. And we were actually one of the small areas, only 300 houses without power here. There were some parts of town, 3,000 houses, households, without power. Well, it's also a new moon. And the new moon is a beautiful crescent up there. You can see Venus up there just above it to the right. It's really a splendid sight. If I could just keep this camera from shaking. I don't have it on a tripod tonight. There's the planet. Now Jupiter is right over around there somewhere, but it's still a little too bright to see it. So a few minutes from now maybe I'll get a look at it, but I've only got a couple minutes time left on the battery on this camera. So, and I'm wasting it by zooming in and out. It's been quite a little eventful day here. What with the thunder and lightning, and we had an inch and a half of rain, which is phenomenal. We've never had that much rain in any day in July in recorded history, which is only about 110, 150 years. But, and we never had a July with as much rain in it. It's quite extraordinary. Climate change, global warming. Ooh. They say we're gonna have more rain this winter. Damn.
But also not telling the whole truth. The church of a Chicago area woman found hanged inside a Texas jail cell this week's planning a Sunday prayer walk in her honor. That is, the investigation into her death continues. Authorities in Texas say the woman hanged herself 3 days after being stopped for a traffic violation and then arrested for allegedly kicking an officer. Friends and families question that account.
That's my battery crank radio. And this is the battery of candles I have lit. There's six of them. Four over here and two over here. And it's 9 o'clock. That was the 9 o'clock news from KNX in Los Angeles. It's 9 o'clock. I'm still feeling quite infuriated because you can see out there most of the city has power, but we do not. And I'm restless. I haven't been able to work since this morning before the storms began. But on the other hand, it's kind of refreshing to feel there's something missing from my life if I'm not working. Now, mind you, I'm a very free sort of guy. I left my gainful employment a few years ago and was lucky enough to have a little bit of money saved from those years of working. And also fortunate enough to discover I could work as a translator. And then the real stroke of fortune when my mother asked me to come and live with her. And I don't have to pay rent here. And I don't have to give her money. She's got her pension. She's all right. So most of my work is writing and some of my video work. I'm working on a movie now that I'm preparing for the Pasadena Film Festival. Got a few more months to go before I have to turn it in. The film festival's next year in the spring, I believe it is. But they're great supporters of independent filmmakers. They don't have a lot of industry films that they show. So I'm hoping maybe they'll show my film. It's not winning a prize. It's just getting people seeing it that matters to me and getting some feedback from other independent filmmakers. And yet, at the same time, I'm missing my vlogging and putting it up and having one or two of you have the kindness and the courtesy to watch my little vlog and comment and tell me what you think and all that. Like I watch yours and tell you what I think of them. It's quite an eye-opening experience not to have power and not be able to work because I'm so dependent upon electricity. Makes me want to get a manual typewriter so that when those days come, when there is no power, I can slam bam away on my old manual typewriter and still do something. Yeah. Well, I see by the indicator I have 4 minutes time left on the hard drive, so I'd better cut this out right now. Goodbye, my friends. seems a bitter mockery of our power outage that now, a few minutes before 10 o'clock, the fireworks at Blackfish Park are shooting off into the sky, while I sit here in darkness in my house without power above Freeway Valley. Well, that's just the way it is. We are the neighborhood struck by lightning, and we have been in darkness for almost 11 hours. Of course, the first 9 hours, it was still daylight. But 2 hours ago, night fell. And now, as the fireworks go off at 10 o'clock, I can only hope that soon we'll have our power back. I'm not so much worried about me as I am about the frozen food. Now, oddly enough, I've been anticipating sometime, sooner or later, we would lose power. So I've been putting gallon bottles of water, plastic bottles, into the freezer. And there's now 7 or 8 gallons of frozen water in there, which is helping to keep the temperature down. I took all the frozen stuff out of the kitchen. And kitchen refrigerator. Oh, look, it's decided it can't focus. Took all the stuff out of the kitchen refrigerator, out of the small freezer, and moved it to the big one out in the garage. And that, I think, will help keep the things frozen for at least another few hours. Looks like the fireworks are over. You can hear them booming, but that's 8 miles away. So it takes almost 30 seconds for the noise to get here. 40, almost 40 seconds. Meanwhile, other parts of town out there across Freeway Valley have their power, but we don't. And I'm sitting here in the pitch black. You can't even see me. Good night, my dear friends. Well, it's about, look at the clock, 10:30 at night in California on the 18th of July, daylight savings time. And about 15 minutes ago, the power finally came back on. So I'm out here. First I had to go in and let my mom know that everything was okay. She'd gone to bed. As soon as it got dark, she went to bed while she could still see in the bathroom. About 8 o'clock, about an hour earlier than she usually does. And so I woke her up about 10:15 and let her know everything's okay, which she'd asked me to do. She was worried. She was afraid we'd have to get up and evacuate with the dog. But no, the power's back on. As you can see, I'm out in my little library room. And I'm trying to put together a video with all the stuff, and this will be the tail end of it, saying,